Hi everyone. Today we're going to use Texas BA2 Plus financial calculator to solve a word problem involving compounding interest. So let's look at the example. Mohammad asked his friend Julie to lend him $10,000 so that he can buy a car. Mohammad will pay the money back in 4 years, and he agreed to pay the interest of 10% per year, compounding annually. How much does Mohammad need to pay back to Julie at the end of the fourth year? Let's first draw a timeline. Mohammad liked to borrow $10,000 now in order to buy a car. This $10,000 is called principal, also present value. We have PV, short for present value. In the future, at the end of the fourth year, so 4 years, Mohammad will pay back Julie the amount, which we don't know how much that's going to be. That's the maturity value, also called future value, FV for future value. In order to solve a compound interest problem, we need to identify 7 variables. First, CY, compounding per year, PY, payments per year. We also need to look at the calculator. We need that 5 button on one row. So we have N, IY, PV, PMT, and FV. So we have present value. We already identified it's $10,000. Future value, the amount Mohammad will pay back, that's unknown. PMT stands for periodic payments. In this case, we don't have periodic payments. So periodic payments are like monthly payments to mortgages or credit debts. In this case, periodic payments is 0. Interest is 10%, 10% interest. For calculator entry, we will drop the percent, just write down 10. The interest compounding annually, that means compounding once a year. So compounding period per year is just 1. For PY, PY represents payments per year. But in this case, our periodic payment is 0. In such cases, PY takes same value as CY. N is number of compounding periods. So we're talking about 4 years period, and the compounding is once a year. So N is 4 times 1 equals to 4. Later on, when we look at examples for annuities, you will see N represent number of periodic payments. In either case, compounding interest or annuity calculations, you can always use the formula N equals to number of years times PY. Now we have all the information we need, and we're ready to use calculator to solve the problem. Okay, so on the calculator, we're going to push on and off button to turn it on. Most calculators by default has 2 decimals, so let's change it to 9 decimals first. Push second and format. Change decimal to 9, so push 9 and enter. Please be careful, if you forget to push the enter key, your number will not be entered properly. Now second quit to exit. Next, we're going to enter the values for CY and PY by enter second PY. First, PY is 1, so push 1, enter. Scroll down, CY by default is same value as PY. Or change it anyway, just 1, enter as a practice. Push second and quit to get out there. Now for this row, N, IY, PV, PMT, and FV. For all these 5 keys, as long as you know 4 numbers, you'll be able to calculate the remaining one. Let's enter value N is 4. So 4, N. So remember you have to push the value first and then the button. For interest rate, is 10 IY, PV is 10,000, PV, PMT is 0. And the future value is unknown. But we already have these four numbers. We'll be able to calculate future value by press compute FV. So future value is $14,641. You'll notice in the future value, it shows negative. That's because PV and FV always take opposite sign, representing cash inflow and cash outflow. You may also consider that as money come at you or money leaving you. So for Mohammad, getting $10,000, that's a cash inflow, and paying out $14,641 is negative. He lose that much money. But if you think from Julie's perspective, Julie would lose $10,000 and gain $14,641. Let's try that. If we change present value to be negative, and now we compute future value, you will see a positive $14,641. It doesn't matter. You just keep in mind they have to be opposite sign when you use the calculator. Now we have solved the problem. Thank you for watching.